Discord paced around Screwball's bedroom, trying to control his frustration. His daughter sat on the bed, glaring down at her hooves while Fluttershy stood a safe distance away from them both. "I'm a reasonable father," Discord ranted. "I let you bend reality. I let you stay up late. I let you eat dessert before dinner. I never asked for much, but yet the one rule I make and the one thing I tell you not to do, you'll go out and break it." "Daddy, you don't understand," Screwball tried to say. "Did you know who that stallion was? I did you?" She hung her head. "Yes." He crossed his arms. "How long have you been seeing that boy?" Screwball looked away. "How many times do I have to tell you? Changelings are dangerous. You can't trust them, especially that one." "You don't even know him," his daughter spat. "Yeah? Well, mother like son, all changelings are the same. Heartless, cold, hideous monsters." "Oh, you're the one to talk." "What?" Screwball then covered her mouth while Fluttershy gasped in horror. Discord narrowed his eyes at his daughter. "Oh," he growled. "So that's how the way you're going to play it, Missy? Well, yes, I may be hideous, but at least I have a heart. Changelings are incapable of any..." "Daddy, I love him!" The sound of that dad made him heard another gasp from Fluttershy. Discord's eyes grew into the size of fire frying pans. "No," he uttered. "Have you lost your mind? He's a changeling! I don't care," Screwball said defiantly. "Can't you see he's bewitched you? He's only seeing the feeding off your emotions. He's only using you. A creature like that cannot love." The young mare could not take it anymore and hopped off the bed. "Oh, you're such a hypocrite." She then raced down towards the door. "I'm not finished with you, young lady," Discord bellowed. "Well, I'm finished." She then threw open the door with her magic and heard some shouts. Behind the door were the tree pies and Prism, Screwball ignoring them and sobbing down the hall. "Screwball, Fluttershy, your conquest," Discord shouted. "You come back here this instant." "Discord," Fluttershy said sternly, laying her hoof on his shoulder. "I think you might have been too hard on her." "Too hard on her?" the Draconic Quest repeated. "She deliberately disobeyed me. On top of that, she used her magic against me and called me a heartless monster." "A hypocritical at that." "But Discord, don't you see?" "Don't I see what?" "This is precisely on how I was treated when I fell in love with you." The Draconic Quest fell silent. He tried to find a proper response, but yet he found none. "Our daughter's right," Fluttershy declared. "You are a hypocrite. You forbid Screwball from falling in love with a changeling when the world forbade me falling in love with you. That was different," Discord insisted. "I loved you back. Changelings are incapable of love. They say they care for you, but once their hunger is satisfied, they stab you in the back." "Honey, I know you're probably too upset to discuss this, but what exactly happened between you and Chrysalis and made you enemies?" He sighed. "It was a long time ago. I was just a kid in the wild, and I met Chrysalis when she was just a princess. Even at her age, she was devious. She did not even seem to mind my appearance, and she said she was my friend. I told her I was looking for a home, and she told me a land where creatures of all kinds are accepted." "Equestria?" Fluttershy guessed. "You got it. Well, she was clearly wrong, but that's not what ticked me off. Years later, I took off her Equestria, newly cornered Chrysalis and her changelings, and took advantage of my Discorder and fed off the ponies." He then looked at his wife sincerely. "She used me. She sent me to Equestria, knowing the ponies would reject me and make me so mad that I would take over, so that she wouldn't have to do it herself." "Are you sure that's what happened?" "Oh, I'm sure. She wasn't at least a bit moodiest when she came to my lair to gloat about it." He groaned and collapsed on the bed. "I wish Screwball would just realize that I just don't want her to get hurt. I certainly just don't want her face the same." "Shh," Fluttershy whispered, stroking his head. "What happened with Chrysalis is in the past now. Maybe her son is different." "How do you possibly know that?" Discord huffed. "I don't, but 17 years ago, I met someone whom every pony thought was a monster. And I thought he was a monster too until I got to know him better. A year later, I married him, and I've been happy ever since. But those changelings, they're evil." "But you were evil too, weren't you?" "Yes, but..." "And you changed, didn't you?" "Yes, but..." "Well, what made you change?" He looked up at her, and all these years that he was still the beautiful thing he's ever seen. And of course, he had an eternal youth spell on her not long after her wedding, so she did not look any different. "You?" Fluttershy smiled. "Because you fell in love with me." He sat up. "It was more than that. You were my everything. My life was incomplete without you in it." He then reached down and caressed her cheek. "I would give up my power for you." "But then, don't you think that Prince Mothball could be the same about Screwball?" He stiffened. He sighed heavy. Maybe you're right. But you can't be too careful. I suppose I should go talk to her. Fluttershy then stroked her head. Give her a minute to calm down. Screwball did not know where else to go. She instantly teleported to her sanctuary. Her first instinct was to sob into her hooves. Why her father could not understand. He was always supportive of her of everything else she did, even though he would never allow her to see Mothball. It seemed to the matter now, and that it figured out her secret. He was going to make sure that she's never left his sight again. It would only be a matter of minutes before he found her. I thought you'd be here. Huh? Sooner than I thought. Go away! She shouted. Huh? Screwball did not even double check and take notice it wasn't her dad's voice. She turned around to see Mothball. She quickly cast a spell to fix her hair and makeup. Sorry, she apologized. I thought you were my dad. What are you doing here? He took a step forth. I came to see if you're okay. Oh yeah, I'm fine. It's just, Daddy and I got into a fight. Oh, I guess that's my fault. No, I was the one who told you to change into yourself. I was also the one who threw my dad into a tree. You see, you know, I never used my magic on him before. We've always been so close and never fought, she sighed. I guess it was bound to happen at some point. She hung her head in silence for a moment, while Mothball cautiously approached and sat down beside her. So how have things been, you know, with the mate and the trouble of your parents? Screwball stiffened. Okay, I guess, she smiled for a bit. I have a baby brother now. The changeling raised his eyebrows. A brother? Yeah, his name is Zany. He's the cutest baby you'll ever see. Does he, do things with to you? I mean, like, can he do magic? She nodded. Although he has trouble controlling it, but wait, I can't wait till he gets older, and that way we can play catch together, and I can show him the wicked curveball. How old is he? 5 months. What about your friends? How are they doing? Dinky and Cinnamon Stick got together at the dance, and so did Thunder and Apple Blossom, I think. She scooted closer to him. A lot of ponies got the courage tonight, too. She tugged and touched his hooves of hers. Told the pony that they liked very well, and that she did not need to say anything. Mothball could feel her emotion. Things were going according to plan. All he had to do was pretend to return to her affections to wriggle more information about her. It was what his mother would want, but it was not what he wanted. He pulled his hoof away. Screwball, you can't. You can't have feelings for a changeling. You can't love something that has no heart to love you back with. Screwball looked at him seriously. Why can't you not see that? See what? This. She took his hoof again and this time placed it over his chest. Feel that? Something inside his chest was pumping rapidly. That's a heartbeat, Screwball stated. Mothball then stared at her in disbelief and then shook his head. That's impossible, he murmured. I'm not supposed to have a heart. I'm exactly what your father says. Cold, unfeeling. If you're so cold and unfeeling, then why haven't you not sucked me dry yet? Because, he could not think of a reason. There were so many candidates. Because I don't want to hurt you, because I'm supposed to keep you alive, I think you're really pretty. He then chose the safest one. You're the only friend I've ever had. He smiled and Mothball could have sworn he heard music. He had figured that it was his imagination until butterflies surrounded them with a heart-shaped pattern. Screwball patted her purple eyes innocently. Sorry, she said. When I get emotional, I get carried away. Exactly who is the seducer here? Once again, he found himself lost in the hypnotic swirls. He did not even know if it was her magic or if it was his eyes truly sparkled. He almost did not realize what he was leaning in until her lips were inches away from his. He wrenched himself away from the spell and was broken. Did you not hear my warning? He snapped. Screwball pouted. I don't care. Well, you should. Don't you think I would be able to live with myself if I hurt? He paused and then shocked at the feelings falling from his mouth. Screwball was equally surprised. Not by his words, but his frightening tone. Mothball decided that he should get out of there before he gave her the wrong idea, so he could sort of strange the thumping inside him. You should go home, he said quickly. Screwball blinked. What? Your family's probably worried sick about you. She sighed. I guess you're right. I guess I'm in enough of trouble as it is. When will I see you again? Mothball looked away. Wouldn't get your hopes up. But it's for your own safety, Screwy. I think it's best you stay away. It pained him to say it more than ever because the first time he had left, this time it was for real. Screwball knew that he was not lying. He heard the sniff and resist the urge to look at her, knowing that the eyes were filling up with tears. Goodbye, he muttered. Mothball took off before he could change his mind, and Screwball's ears dropped and began to cry for the second time that evening. She did not go back to Canterlot. She felt that she had no choice. Her parents would flip if she did not return home soon. Any sign of her? Fluttershy asked her friends. Applejack shook her head. We looked everywhere. Discord was growing nervous. You don't think she ran away, did she? and Screwball materializes in front of him, breathes a sigh of relief. Oh, thanks, Celestia. Where have you been, young lady? Fluttershy demanded, crossing her hooves. I was just getting some air. Screwball mumbled, not making any contact with any pony. Scurry, I want to talk about, her father started to say. She turned his head back to him. I don't want to talk right now. I just want to go to bed. Disco scowled. How dare you turn your back on me? You come back here all. Let her go, honey, Fluttershy said, taking his paw into her hooves. It's been a long night, and she needs some rest. We could all use some rest, Twilight declared. All the others agreed and departed for their bedrooms, except for Rarity, who tapped on the yellow Pegasus' shoulder. Fluttershy, may I speak with you? Fluttershy looked up at her husband, and, of course, after the family dispute, Discord needed her especially now, but Rarity's expression was so desperate. This will only take a moment, dear. The Draconoquest nodded solemnly and left the two mares alone. How do you make this work? Rarity asked suddenly. Fluttershy's eyes widened. What do you mean? Your marriage. It can't be easy. I mean, don't you two ever fight? But of course, married couples get into fights all the time. Then how are you still together? Well, the thing with fights is that we argue about something that is bothering us, and then after the fight, we try to fix it. If we never talk about our problems to each other, how will we know which one is troubling the other? But, Rarity stammered, don't most marriages end because of a fight? Rarity shook her head. Fights are normal. Of course I didn't know how to think of marriage breakup due to a lack of fight. Fancy Pants and I never fought until the unicorn trailed off, which caught Fluttershy's attention. Until what? Rarity, you could tell me anything. Whatever it is, I won't talk about with anyone. Cross my heart and hope to fly, stick a cupcake in my eye. Rarity smiled a little, took a deep breath. I caught Fancy Pants with another mare. Fluttershy gasped. What? When? The whole story came pouring out. A few days later, after Screwball and Dinky's birthday, Fancy Pants told me he was going out to lunch with a friend. While I was shopping, Upper Crust, he said that he saw him in the cafe with his old mare friend, Philo de Lis, and I tried telling myself that it was only a casual meal, but I was curious and asked Upper Crust to lead me to them, and when we got there, her filthy hooves were all over him in public, nonetheless. Humiliated and hurt, I rushed home, packed my things, and left Fancy Pants a note. I picked up Gemstone from her piano lessons and then hopped on the train to Ponyville. As the tears sprung Rarity's eyes, the Pegasus stood speechless. She tried to process Fancy Pants would never do such a thing. He had always be a gentle colt, all of them. Maybe it wasn't what you think, Fluttershy suggested. And what if it is? Rarity snapped. Did you ever talk to Fancy Pants about this? Well, no. I was just so upset, I couldn't talk to him. I even haven't told Gemstone about it. Then how do you know what this has happened? The unicorn said nothing. Look, I won't say anything, but you should not have left something like this unsaid, especially to Fancy Pants. If you discuss this with the matters with him, it will never be resolved. Rarity looked up at her friend in the eye. You're right, I shouldn't hold in my anger. I must speak to Fancy Pants, which that means I should throw the divorce papers away. Fluttershy grinned. That's good, Rarity, but I need to sleep on it. Sleep on it, thank you, Fluttershy. You are really the best friend ever pony could ever love. Twilight then did not mean to eavesdrop. She had to return to ask Fluttershy about the changeling that she had overheard the conversation with Rarity. It got Unicorn thinking about her situation with Flash. They never really talked about what happened 5 years ago. Perhaps maybe it was the time they did. Since she was also thinking of what occurred with Screwball and the changeling, whom Discord claimed Queen Chrysalis's heir, Screwball then had turned against her father to defend the boy. Twilight wanted to know why. Mothball arrived at the hive and his mother was waiting. What did you find out from the halfling? She asked. The prince then turned away from her. I don't want any part of this anymore, mother. Queen Chrysalis narrowed her eyes. What did you say? I said I don't want any part of this anymore. The elder changeling gritted her teeth. You are disagreeing. Are you disagreeing with me? Mothball faced her defiantly. Maybe I am. What are you going to do about it? Furious, her horn glowed green and blasted a beam at him, sticking him to the wall. No one defies me. Chrysalis bellowed, stepping forward towards him, especially my own son. Now tell me what you know. Mothball was scared of his wits. He had never stood up to his mother before, and she never used his force on him. Nevertheless, he kept his courage. I don't care what you do to me. Why can't you leave just that family alone? Chrysalis growled. I should have known you're too weak for the task. She smirked. Then I know precisely what makes you weak, halfling. She's something valuable to you, is she not? Mothball then froze in fear, causing Chrysalis grin in triumph. Oh, I see she is. If I cannot get any information from you, I could always go straight up to the source. No, he protested. You can't. Please don't hurt her. You don't want her hurt? The queen cackled. Then tell me what I need to know.